And let's do another Beaten Angel. Is it bad that I barely understand any conversations here because I'm not really that into the Sith? I mostly just come here to hang out. Well, I appreciate you dropping in, Gaboss. I know that a lot of it is kind of very much in talk based on the, you know, Love Live brand. With a little bit of Idolmaster thrown in right now. Feels like my fingers are getting lazy. They're like, no, don't make me play this fast song. Play something easy. Why do you think you would ever stream anything other than Love Live? I have in the past, Kate Cat. I streamed some visual novel stuff. I streamed Tales of Graces a little bit. I think I streamed some Rogue Legacy. But yeah, you know, I've considered it, but I mostly just kinda like to record stuff most of the time. And then just post them to YouTube. I think a lot of it is that I generally, like, I really enjoy narrative-focused games in general, a lot of, for, you know, the most part, really, when I'm not playing Love Live. And when it comes in and you're doing that kind of a stream, you know, if you are going to make a VOD of it, spoilers become kind of a problem. So that's kind of been an issue. Hey, yeah, there you go, Kaboss is already talking about what I said there. Used to play Rogue Legacy, yeah. But, like Kaboss said, it's been a long time since I really did anything like that. I streamed Fate Stay Night for a bit. I mean, you can find all this in my VODs for Twitch, too. I streamed all of DeCapo 2. I streamed Family Project. A lot of visual novels. Nowadays, though, it's just like, Love Live! Love Live! Ooh, a new preview for Siron's single. I know that's one of the subunits, but... You know, Last Tip is a very narrative-focused game. No, but seriously, I do tend to play mostly those kinds of games when I'm not playing Civ. I should probably start a new song, too, because it's literally at the point where I'm wasting LP. The new Prince Imps. Oh, there we go. That's exactly how I think of it, then. Yeah. Yeah, I've told myself numerous times, like, I need to stream more and stuff like that, but, I just haven't done it. You know, recently, I've only recently, frankly, gotten the, kind of the motivation back to start recording for my YouTube channel again. And that only really happened because I got really interested in Danganronpa, so I just recorded me playing that. I still gotta go back and finish two series that I was in the middle of on that channel. I don't know what kind of game I would want to stream on Twitch at this point, because I kind of came to the conclusion that visual novels are like real bad content for Twitch, just because they're the sort of thing you can't really come into the middle of and really understand what's going on, unless it's just a slice of life game. Those are easy enough to just pop in and be like, hey, I get this. But, yeah. Because, you know, I don't really play, like, first-person shooters or anything like that. I play some MMOs. Well, I should say I play a MMO. I play some Star Wars The Old Republic in my spare time, but I don't really think anyone wants to watch me roll my 48th character in that or anything. So, yeah, no. What was that VN you were streaming where it ended up going on a, you ended up going on a tangent for like 2 hours, ended up with the horror one about the murder in the house. You had to keep going over and over and over and over again, and it kept getting stranger and stranger. Is that Umineko you're talking about? I went on a tangent for like 2 hours? Horror one about the murder in the house. You had to keep going over and over again, and it got stranger and stranger. I don't know if it's not Umineko, Kaboss. I really don't. I will watch Swator all day long. Well, maybe I need to stream some Swator for you, Kaboss. So why did you ever finish the Swator expansion playthrough? No, I didn't, K-Cat. I got to, like, Chapter 6. And I haven't played any more of it. And they're up to chapter, like, 12 now. I've played all of them. I just haven't recorded me playing through them. And I haven't messed with that character either, because I'm always like, yeah, I'll go back and do it. But I haven't recorded anymore. It's still going, though. A new chapter of that comes out on the 3rd of next month, I think? And I'm looking forward to it, because a character that I like in Swator is coming back for that. Vet! Yeah. We were talking and you went through like 3 other VNs? What? I don't remember this, Kaboss. My memory is trash. And also, I'm about to level up, I just realized. I can't play right now as my computer can't play it anymore. Oh, that sucks, Kaboss. If you ever start playing again, let me know. I think I play on the, I think it's Beregrine Colony server. Time for Date Date. It was a weird conversation. Well, you know. It is us. And it was an Umineko. What did I go on a tangent about, out of curiosity? Was it about the game? Because I like Umineko a lot. I mean, you know, I have some slight issues with it. But I have a lot of fun with it, because it's a game that, again, kind of basks in being insane. I'm trying to think of other games coming out that I'm interested in. Like, I know I'm gonna get and play Mirror's Edge 2 because I really liked Mirror's Edge 1. I was one of those people. I know there's a lot of people that liked it, a lot of people that, you know, hated it, but I liked it a lot. So I don't know, maybe when I get Mirror's Edge 2, I'll stream that. Provided that, you know, it streams well. Because that's not something I would intend to, you know, really do any kind of YouTube coverage on, or anything anyway, so. If any of you would be interested in watching me play kind of a more traditional game, maybe I'll do that. I think that comes out in like a month or something. It started with a VN about a guy who lived in a storage container. Okay, I don't remember that. Guy who lived in a storage container. So why do you have two YouTube channels? Yeah, I do, KitKat. My YouTube channel names are Phantom Zwei, which is my YouTube channel about visual novels. Like, I just post visual novel stuff there. And then Phantom Null. N-U-L-L is kind of where I post other stuff. It's like where I have my Swator playthroughs, that's where I have my Sif streams, you know, the ones that don't get flagged for copyright and muted anyway. So yeah, I have two. Guy that lived in a storage container. Oh! Oh! That's Chaos Head! Yeah! Chaos Head. Man, I almost forgot I streamed that. That was nuts. About multiple VNs, Umineko was one. I think it was about VNs in general and what was good about some. Yeah, I've gone on multiple rants and tirades about that in the past, that's for sure. Mirror's Edge is awesome. Totally with you, Kaboss. I'd watch you play Mirror's Edge. Good to know. Maybe I will stream Mirror's Edge too. You know, at least give it a shot. All I know about Mirror's Edge is there's a weird lady that does parkour. That's pretty much it, Mijimaru fan. The story in that game is stupid, so... Or at least in the first one it was stupid. So that's really all you need to know, in my opinion. Yeah. He was an otaku, yeah, that was Chaos Head. That was, gosh, what was that guy's name? I don't even remember the main character's name of Chaos Head anymore. I want to say it started with a T? He hated going outside, it was a weird one that I popped in the middle of. Yeah, Chaos Head. And that game started good, but ended bad, in my opinion. Hey, Shizoku, good to see you. How you doing? Good to see you in the chat today. Man, I wanted Chaos Head to be good so bad, too. I remember the first time I played it. Basically, it was a Nitro Plus game. And one of my favorite visual novels, at least back in the day, I don't know how well it would hold up these days if I played it, but it's actually where my namesake comes from, Phantom Zwei. It was Phantom Inferno, which is one of Nitro Plus's first visual novels. So, you know, I played Chaos Head. Oh, this is gonna be awesome, and it started out so good, and the mystery was so good, and then it went too sci-fi. And I was sad. And it's another visual novel that I think kind of suffers a little bit from... I mean, that visual novel is not completely kinetic, but your choices didn't matter. At all, so... I think that kind of hurt it for me a little bit, too. But yeah, I remember now a lot more about what you're talking about, now that I remember what game you're talking about, Kaboss. Wasn't that a Halloween stream? Didn't I stream that around Halloween? And we went through the whole thing over the period of, like 3 or 4 days or something. That was like 4 years ago or something now. I remember watching Chaos Head when Funimation was still on TV. I heard the anime is terrible. I have no idea if that's true, Mijimaru fan, but I was even disappointed by the game, so I can only imagine that the anime was bad. It was a weird time in everyone's lives. Well, for some of us, that never changes. Actually, I've already played Beaten Angel like 48 times this stream. Let's play Beaten Angel, or... yeah, instead of Beaten Angel, let's play Beaten Angel. Let's play Otome Shiki. Looks like 2 episodes of Chaos Head dropped it. Yeah. I imagine it's pretty bad. Not Nitro Plus's best work. Of course, I haven't really played many Nitro Plus games since then. I played some of, oh gosh, what is it called? Oh yeah, Demon's Bane. Deus Ex Demon's Bane, I think, is what it's called. And I played Sayano Uta. Sayano Uta is completely screwed up. Unless you want to get involved in something completely screwed up, don't even bother looking up what it is. But yeah, Demon's Bane, I didn't really know how I felt about it as I played it, but I could say that I wasn't terribly intrigued because I never finished it. It's weird, like, I felt like I really liked Nitro Plus's identity back in its early days, and, you know, kind of the stuff I played later on, I was less interested in. I don't know. Ah! So I should look at the pick if you have time. Okay. Okay. Koto Honk, Lumirin, Niko Maki, Nozo Ellie, Ellie Umi, Koto Panna, Niko Umi, Rin Honk, Maki Umi. That's pretty funny. That's pretty funny. I was confused at first, but it kept my interest after school. Well, you know, at least it's good for that, right? Some of those combinations of Muse Kids are kind of weird. It's also weird going into your old videos and seeing the ones that started weird conversations in chat. Like the ending of DeCapo 2. Are you talking about on... like, in the comment section of YouTube, or are you talking about in the stream? Guess that wasn't bad, looked great first time. If you're a manga fanatic, you'll hate it. I just know I didn't like the game. Do you ship Niko Maki? Lightning, I've never been a person who really got too interested in shipping the characters together, but I guess if there is someone I shipped with either of them, it would be Niko Maki, so I guess yes. In the stream, okay. I don't even remember the conversation that was sparked by it. I remember that, to this day, DiCapo 2 is still one of my, like, guilty pleasures. And when DiCapo 3 comes out, I know I'm gonna definitely do a series on that. So love Marginal again. What can I say? I like it. Now you're gonna make me want to go back and look at the DiCapo 2 video just to see what happened. It's weird, like, I've been really into, like, shipping certain characters with other characters in other series before. But in Love Live, I don't know, I just never... That was never a thing that I really cared about. But maybe not really into it, that's overstating it a little. But I definitely had my preferences, I should say. I thankfully was never one of those people who would get on message boards and scream as loud as they could. Best ship! Still haven't played it or the first one. The first one, honestly, Kvass is... I wouldn't go back to it. Like, you know, for the time, it was, you know, kind of a fun slice of life game with, you know, visual novel with some very light fantasy elements. But, yeah, you know. These days, you know, production is a lot better. Oh man, chat is so into the character pairing game right now. Yeah, you kind of don't have our conversation in the video because it was just random stuff put together. Oh yeah, okay, that makes sense. Kappa 2 video ends while you're still talking. Okay. I wonder if that's still in the VOD, because I think I have the VOD still on Twitch. But then again, I think I had to cut those into... Yeah, that's right. I know I had to cut those into segments because, you know, Twitch changes policy, like, what was it, like a year and a half ago? So they were deleting their back catalog of your videos unless they were, you know, so long and they were highlights and not just past broadcasts. They deleted all those. So, I don't remember what I did with those. I think I still have those up. I think I have them. It might even just be in, like, really long one single segments, but I think I do. And actually, give me a second. I didn't pay attention to my experience until now. Doing a little quick math. Shipping myself with Nozo, shipping Zwei with Maki, and shipping all of you with your waifus. There you go, Lightning. How would I go look? I don't use Twitch. See, it's different when you're a broadcaster. For me, I just... Have you played or watched Steins Gate? Yeah, I have a full playthrough of Steins Gate up on my channel, Otherworldly Learner, if you're interested in that. How's Maki going? It's going well, Shizoku. I've been playing the hell out of it the past few days, but work is gonna start getting in the way as of tomorrow, so... Shipping myself with Nozo, shipping Zwei with Maki, and shipping all of you with your waifus. There you go, Lightning. How would I go look? I don't use Twitch. See, it's different when you're a broadcaster. For me, I just, you know, click on, what was it, previous videos or whatever. I say I don't use Twitch enough either. Yeah, Video Manager. I think you have to click on the streamer's name to go to their back catalog. I think. But anyway, let's see. Okay. Let me play Beaten Angel. Oh, jeez. That's another thing that I streamed, actually. And that was kind of like the last visual novel that I streamed on my channel was Steins Gate, actually. And then after that, that's kind of when I came to the conclusion that, you know, I don't think that I really should probably stream visual novels, the whole thing, on my channel. I mean, it's fun for the people that can stick around and, you know, watch most of it. But for people who can't, you know, they have to catch up through the VODs. And, you know, if you're streaming a lot, then they can just, they just come in and they're just kind of lost. That kind of stuff is just easier to post to YouTube and have people watch it at their leisure, I think. But who knows, maybe I'll change my mind to that again. I've gone back and forth on it before. But you know, a game like Sif, you don't have to know anything about anything to come in here and just be like, hey, he's... Look at him tap those anime girls to the rhythm. It simply is what it is. I ship too much. Love the anime, so if the game is half as good, I will still enjoy it. I think it's really good. I've not watched the anime, Otherworldly Learner. Even though I, you know, more than once I've been like, I need to do that. But the game is really good. I enjoy it a lot. Steins Gate has a game where... Oh yeah, Steins Gate was originally a visual novel. That's where it came from. You can find it translated. You can probably find it on Jast USA, J-List. Just look it up. I almost full combo beat an angel last night before bed. 510 combo or so. Oh man. That sucks, Shizoku. I always seem to find my fave anime is games slash visual novels. Yeah, and the thing is, usually the games are better, just because anime has the problem of being condensed. You know, at least in my experience. But that's not always true, obviously. Yeah, even just my playthrough of Steins Gate, which was admittedly completely blind, but that was 52 videos, and every video is like almost an hour, I think. So, yeah. It's a lot. Curious, how many videos was that? I'll look that up. I always seem to find my fave anime is games slash visual novels. Yeah, and the thing is, usually the games are better, just because anime has the problem of being condensed. You know, at least in my experience. But that's not always true, obviously. Yeah, even just my playthrough of Steins Gate, which was admittedly completely blind, but that was 52 videos, and every video is like almost an hour, I think. so yeah. It's a long game. People ship the Azawa siblings? What? A lot of anime are adapted from them. That's true. Okay, let's play Trouble Busters. I know this holds no weight, but Steins Gate is rated number one anime on Anime News Network. Interesting. Steins Gate is just really well written, too, you know? Obviously, I'm not going to go into spoilers, don't worry about that, anyone who's interested in it. But, you know, if you're looking for an interesting anime with kind of a time travel theme, any kind of sci-fi that you're interested in, Steins Gate can be quite good, in my opinion. And it's one of those visual novels that's not even kinetic. Like, you can kind of make choices that influence the ending. Well, not kind of, you can make choices that influence the ending. Which is cool. Take it easy, Kit Kat. Thanks for dropping in. Good to see you. Persona's anime is the best. Persona 4 did have a fun anime. I prefer to play the game, personally, but I did enjoy the anime. Canterbury is an original animation this season, though. Oh, wow. Pfft. I just leveled up. I thought for some reason I had less than 83 to go. Well, I just wasted 25 LP there. No big deal, I guess. But that was silly of me. And yeah, rank 292. 171 LP. Huzzah. That was my soft goal, I think, for this event. To reach level 292, so... you know, definitely achieved that pretty quick. Kotaro's like 5, right? Yeah, maybe a little early. I still want to play Steins Gate, but I haven't got the chance to purchase it. Eh, just something to keep in mind, Shizuku. It's not going anywhere. The Yukio is 14. It's a little young, I'd say. Just saying. Ship Yukio and Alyssa? People actually ship the siblings? What? Yeah, I love how they integrate real-world events into it. Yeah, it's really cool. Steins Gate is really good. Going to check now because I'm curious. Back but playing League, so I won't be talking much. Welcome back, Bomber. The stream's not going to last much longer anyway. I'm probably going to last another 15 minutes and then head off to get some dinner. It's easy to forget that the girls are that young. Monica's 16, man. Little whippersnappers!
You kids and your Mews and your iPads and your rhythm games. Get off my lawn!
Oshisoku. I don't think you want to say that about yourself. That's me, IRL. That's me when I see, like, crying kids in the supermarket. But actually, it's more like me grumbling, like, frickin' stupid parents, take care of your goddamn kids. But I do get that, that kind of a very irritable, you know, kind of, I don't even know how to put it. Just you become irritable in general, I guess. Some kids who constantly yell outside where I live. I just want to yell at them, but I don't. Yeah, you're probably like me. You don't really get aggressive about things, but you stew inside and just rage. I do the same thing. Unless it's somebody I know and I feel more comfortable like talking to me. Like, look, that's not cool. 16 is technically legal if you have consent or 20 or younger, right? Sure, otherworldly learner. That sounds right. We're old, Zwei. That we are. Feels bad, man. Say how old he is. You're talking about Kotaro? I go away for 10 minutes and this is what I come back to in chat. That's right, Kabas. You're the glue that holds everything together. The second you go away, shit just falls apart. Also call me Owl. Okay, I'll try to remember that. Owl. But, no promises. Reached my goal on Maki, which is clear all the event songs from my profile. Oh, cool. Congrats, Shizoku. Can't find the video. Ah, well, it might have gotten gone during the whole Twitch kind of purge, like a year and a half ago or whatever. That sucks, but, you know, what can you do? Thanks for looking, though. Did you get Maki already, Shizoku? There you are. 24,726. And you get Maki at, what, like 30k? I forget. There she is. Oh, it's that early. Herp-a-derp. Okay, so you long since got Maki. Didn't get her, don't want her. Oh, how dare you, Shizoku. I thought you already got her. So don't you get her at 1,100? Oh, those... I'm looking at rank, not points. Whoops. Never mind. Never mind. I was looking at rank. I'm silly. What if Kotaro is actually an immortal wizard that has lived since the beginning of time? Well, I suppose that's possible. But I would say it is probably a little unlikely. If that's the case, then God help our souls, you know, where we're gonna need it. Because when Kotaro gets tired of his little snotty facade as Nico's little brother, then we're all doomed. Hail Satan. Is Nico an immortal witch? The Kappa video isn't even complete either. It's not? You're talking about in the VOD on Twitch, Kaboss? I'm only getting the SR, not tiering at all. Yeah, you know. This is what it is. I got that card on JP, that's cool. Stiegel. Don't know how to spell, it's all redhead from a certain magical index. It's recorded as being 14. I recently just finished playing Fire Emblem Fates. And in that there's a witch named Nyx, who is, like, trapped in the body of a child, basically. And she can't age, basically, because of a curse. So that kind of reminds me of her, since I've recently played that. It ends a little bit after the vid on YouTube. Oh, at least it's a little longer, I guess. But, you know, it is what it is. Yeah, on YouTube, I probably just cut it out immediately after the ending of the game. If my channel were bigger, you know, I've thought about this before, like, it would be fun to kind of have, like, conversations, you know, about, you know, visual novels, like, you know, discuss their plot and stuff, and kind of have the chat, you know, in the video, and have slides that kind of coincided, and just kind of discuss the characters and plot points and stuff like that, but, like, you know, there would be, like, one or two people in the chat, so it would be a disaster. But if it was big enough, that would be really cool. Or at least it would from my extremely nerdy perspective. I think most people would probably say, no, that does not qualify as cool. That qualifies as extremely dorky. But! It's the kind of thing that I get into, I guess. Always that part. It is always that part that I screw up. Man. I'm going to set up for Danganronpa. Take it easy, Zwei. Cool, Shizoku. If you're playing the first game, then, you know, I'll probably actually drop by your stream later. You know, I'll probably be grinding, so I doubt I'll talk much, but I'll probably turn it on, because now I've played the first game, so I can totally actually, you know, enjoy it without spoilers. All the Azawa siblings are magical except for Nico. She's the chosen one that will use cuteness magic to rule the world. Wow, it all comes together. You're like the new illusion for chat, Fashionista. There used to be a chatter that came around my streams a lot back when I did stream digital novels named Illusion. And he came up with all these crazy-ass conspiracies and stuff that kept chat very lively. So I'm passing the baton officially on to you. That is now your responsibility. Good luck. I need this event to end for Cyberhonk. Nah, no, definitely not, Mijimaru. This must continue on for as long as possible. Like a minute or 2 minutes. Ah, so it's really short, Honka Boss. I got Cyber Katori non-idolized. Congrats, Owl. Now, if you let our convo go for 20 minutes before you cut it, you started on the difference between Shuffle and Decapo 2. Yeah, that was one of those things that I felt pretty passionately about. The Shuffle game is such freaking garbage compared to even the anime. And I still feel that way. That sounds awesome as well. It's a fun idea, Kaboss. I just wish that, again, you know, I kind of had a bigger community that's made it viable. I mean, I guess you can still kind of do that stuff in, you know, like comments in YouTube and stuff, but if it were live, that would allow a back-and-forth kind of conversation. So that would be fun, but maybe one day. You never know. The siblings need Nico for the ultimate spell because they will never be teenagers. Yes, it's just a fact that in anime, you never age. Shuffle has some really cute girls. Aoi is best girl. That's the main sort of girl, right? With the green hair. See, I don't even remember anyone's name anymore. It's been such a long time. Yeah, Shuffle does have some cute girls. The thing is, I watched the anime, and then I was like, oh, the visual novel's being translated. Awesome! This will be great. And then I played the visual novel, and I was like, wow, the visual novel is freaking garbage. The anime is better than the visual novel. This, like, never happens, but that was one of those rare cases. We were talking about it earlier, how it's usually not the case, but the Shuffle anime is straight up better than the visual novel. The visual novel is trash, in my opinion. Maybe not trash, but it's not very good. Trash might be a little harsh. It all makes sense now. Nico Nico Ni is her spell! I partake. Like I said, maybe one day, Kaboss. Maybe one day, but, you know, it would be a disaster if I tried something like that right now. Oh, Aoi from Danganronpa. Okay, I thought you were talking about, from Shuffle. But yeah, I am absolutely with you, Aoi. Aoi is best girl. Easily. I only know Aoi from Aikatsu. I don't even know what that is. Listening to you go on about it has given me more VNs to try. You were also the reason I found Katawa Shoujo. Yeah, you know, that's cool. At the same time, Katawa Shoujo isn't exactly a game I feel extremely strongly about, but I don't know, do you, Kaboss? Like, I feel like it's, you know, it's entertaining, has some good moments. I didn't even play all the routes or anything, but, you know, at the same time, you can't beat the price. Free. Doesn't get any better than free. More recently, kind of an idea I'd been tossing around in my head, you know, which is ironically just something I thought about while I was suffering from insomnia one night. Just could not get to sleep. And this was back before I started doing anything back on my YouTube channel again, but I was like, you know, meaning to, thinking, you know, I've kind of thrown the idea of doing something like that around, but I don't know if I actually want to do it. Because I am enjoying doing some Let's Plays. And I always go back and forth in that in my head. It's like, the reviews are, like, my most watched content on my YouTube channel by far, is the reviews I did for some visual novels. So clearly that's kind of what the most people are interested in. But I have more fun doing the Let's... Scoring systems, the older I get, the more I kind of dislike them. They're really arbitrary, in my opinion. But, you know, basically, I was like, what would I call something like that? And I was like, oh, the visual novel verdict. VN verdict. You know, I've kind of thrown the idea of doing something like that around, but I don't know if I actually want to do it. Because I am enjoying doing some Let's Plays, and I always go back and forth in that in my head. It's like, the reviews are, like, my most watched content on my YouTube channel by far, is the reviews I did for some visual novels. So clearly that's kind of what the most people are interested in, but I have more fun doing the Let's Plays. Because it's just more informal and off the cuff, and I can just, you know, sit down and record, you know, so long as, you know, I'm not too tired to really get into it. But anyway, that's quite a ramble there. Because the ultimate spell is an idol performance at the Love Live, charged with magic to kill the gods with the Nico Nico Ni. Wow, the gods are in danger now of Nico. This has just escalated even further. Aikatsu Stars is great so far. Is that an anime on currently? Ichimaru, I imagine. I love it. I've played every route except for Shizune's. Yeah, I never played hers either. I didn't play hers, and I didn't finish Lily's, I think. I started her route, and then I didn't, you know, I didn't finish it. I just kind of stopped playing and never went back to it. I've never particularly enjoyed student council characters, and she's very harsh. Chiharu is a great character from the DR. Oh yeah, she's in Danganronpa 2, right? Isn't she the ultimate gamer girl? Sounds pretty cool, I'd watch it. Lily is my favorite in Kadowa Shoujo. Why not both? Well, why not both is ideal, but at the same time, it's hard to keep up consistent content, you know, if I'm going to do both of them in particular. I mean, both of them would be ideal. And the thing is, with Danganronpa, like, I got so into it that I recorded so much of it that actually I have a huge backlog right now, which is great. But I'm not always in that position. So. Oh, that's Chiaki. Okay. Are you talking about Chihiro then? Not Chiharu? Rin was my favin. Kadowa Shoujo. Rin was fun. And an interesting character, surprisingly. She's pretty deep. I don't remember, like, much about her route, though, sadly. But what can you do? But yeah, it's getting really late. Not really, really late here, but it's food time. I'm hungry. So, I think I'm just going to sit here and chat with chat for a few minutes, and I think that's going to be it for me playing for today, though. So, I'll just kind of keep going for a few minutes here. We'll finish up talking a little bit. Two, good luck and cheers. Thanks so much. I'll take it while it lasts. Everything is made better with a smiley. That's just fact. Never actually played Danganronpa before, but people said if I like Persona, I should try it. Yeah, as long as you don't necessarily mind... Well, actually, I don't want to really spoil things, but basically, it's one of those games where characters may not necessarily be safe. I'll just say that. I mean, it's themed around, you know, mystery murders, so I guess what do you expect, but... It was a mindfuck. Maki doesn't mind this kind of weather. I, however, do mind this kind of weather, because it's getting hot. But yeah. She got the chance to go into the art gallery. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. That's probably why I don't remember it, actually. Like, I do remember the whole art gallery thing now, but... Man. Corpse party characters were never safe anyway. Oh, yeah. Actually, you know, Shizoku was in here earlier. I actually watched all of Corpse Party in his stream. If you guys are looking for someone who does, you know, some good... Well, a lot of anime-themed games and stuff. Shizoku is a really good streamer. He does a lot more traditional stuff than I do, you know, like we've been talking about. You know, these days I mostly just stream Sif, but Shizoku, he streams all the time. He's streaming now, apparently, with Danganronpa. That's probably what I'll do, is I'm going to host Shizoku, actually, and if anyone's interested in watching some Danganronpa, check it out. Shizoku streams some fun stuff. So, I'm just going to check over on his Twitch channel to see if he's streaming Danganronpa 1 or 2, and then host him up after I let you guys know what he's doing. Okay, he is streaming Danganronpa 1, so I will probably head over there once I get some food. But yeah, let me host Shizoku here. Apparently Corpse Party is coming on 3DS now. Is it? Are they changing anything on the new version? Okay, let's see. And in just a second, I'm going to be hosting Shizoku. Not sure it was only announced. Okay. Interesting. Anyway, guys, that's going to end the stream for today. Thanks for hanging out. It was a lot of fun. We had a pretty good crowd and a lot of varied conversation. Tons of talk about visual novels, lots of talk about Love Live, lots of stuff about the new Sunshine series, a lot of talk about Muse. I like it. This is, you know, a really good day for chat, I think. It was a lot of fun. So thank you guys. Thank you guys for coming out, making a lot of fun. And, yeah, I will talk to you guys next time. Have a good one.